Yo, what's up? Welcome to Slack Happenings episode 2. We got a pretty good response from the first episode, so I think we're gonna keep it going. Here's this week's Slackline news coming at you.
Yeah, so first off, Slacktivity, we all know that brand. They just released a rangefinder, which, as far as I know, is the first Slackline company to make a rangefinder for slacklining. It can go up to 1,000 meters, and it can do your trigonometry, so it can measure the angles. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's ideal. I mean, it's always just super nice to have a rangefinder, especially when you're establishing new highlines. That'll be sweet.
If you're scouting, it's the tool to have.
Yeah, of course, the big highline news of the week, Ryan Robinson sent the longest bridge-to-bridge highline ever in the world at 1,919 feet.
600 meters.
About 600 meters in Folsom, California. That's a big line. I think like the most impressive part of that walk was the number of people that were watching him. Like, imagine the pressure.
A huge crowd.
Yeah.
I mean, he walked over to the crowd too.
Yeah. Which is like, there are people in floaties in the water just like gazing up at him.
Is that the longest line in California now?
I'm not sure. So if anybody knows if that's the longest line in California,
let us know.
Let us know. But major props to Ryan. You gotta love the news coverage on that story.
Yeah.
I loved the news interview of him standing on the line.
I'll take this opportunity to say, hi mom, I'm okay. I'm super safe. Gosh. See? Got my leash on. I'm gonna be alright, I promise.
As most of you already know, Land Cruising Slacklines closed down a while ago, probably a few months ago. Word on the street is they're back under a new name, Aki Slacklines. I don't know if I'm saying that right, A-K-I. We'll leave a link in the description.
For sure.
But they're selling unicorn webbing there, some of the other Land Cruising stuff like the Lynx weblock. So if you're into their stuff, definitely go check that out.
Yeah, it sounds like it was one of the owners of Land Cruising Slacklines
that's just coming back. Yeah, Stefan Junghan. Sorry if I pronounced that wrong. He was one of the founders of Land Cruising, inventor and designer behind all the hardware. He's running the new Aki Slacklines, so
yeah,
cool stuff.
Yeah, it should be cool to see if they come out with some new gear or at least continue the old stuff.
Continue innovating the game, so hopefully we'll see some new stuff.
Absolutely. There was a big Texas waterline gathering this weekend. Those Austin Slackliners put together a nice little waterline gathering. I actually went down there.
Oh yeah.
Despite an attack, a fiery fire ant attack on the waterline gathering, I think the weekend went pretty smoothly. So props to the Texas guys for putting on a really cool event.
You gotta love slacklining over water, huh?
Absolutely, man. Yeah, it was the perfect leash fall. So leash fall, your toes would dip. So it was perfect. Yeah, in other news, it looks like Slack FR seems to be going out of business, or at least liquidating.
Yeah, if you've been following them on any of their social media, they have been pretty much putting everything on a sale, which can only mean one thing.
It looks like they're going under.
We wish them the best.
There are some balance community rumors circulating. It sounds like
new webbing, possibly, yeah.
It sounds like there could be some new webbing in the works. Yeah, Jerry and the crew are putting out what looks like a blue and a green webbing.
Yes, I've personally walked on the green webbing.
Really?
Yes, in Moab.
I personally have as well.
It was nice.
It was quite enjoyable. So we'll have to see. The rumors, I guess, are that the green webbing is going to be nylon and the blue is going to be polyester. And Jerry actually sent a sample of the blue webbing. It was just a short sample to a Colorado slackliner, but should be coming out soon, I would imagine.
It feels pretty good on the hands, nice and soft.
Yeah,
so
that'll be interesting. That. The ISA announced a slackline rigging course in the Netherlands this June.
Certification.
That's a good distinguishment because they did say you have to be already pretty much a knowledgeable rigger for this course.
And it's just,
so I guess it's a certification to make sure rigging is more standardized across festivals and events, which could be a good thing.
Yeah,
to make sure people know what they're doing, and maybe
especially now that gatherings are more common and becoming more official, I think that's the next logical step.
Yeah, and for events that don't know anything about slacklining, having a standardized certification can make
something that you can actually put down on your resume.
Right.
It's going to help a lot.
It can make slacklining more approachable to people that don't know anything about it. I mean, they didn't really put the curriculum of the rigging certification online, but it should be interesting to see what all is going to go into that.
Yeah.
But they've got 25 spots. We'll put the link down below if you're interested. So that's pretty much the Slackline news for the week. We got some content for you.
Show a few clips.
To close out the episode. First of all, there's a Slackline film that came out of India. It's called Free Soul. And it's by Shivam Maher and Bhupash Patil.
Definitely go check it out.
Yeah, it's a really cool film.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, Benny Schmidt on his Instagram threw one of the world's only backflip 360s. I think he's one of two or three people who can do that in the world. So nice, Benny.
Yeah, thanks for watching. If you have any suggestions or pieces of news you'd like included on the next episode, let us know in the comments.
Feel free to reach out to us, and thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching.
See you next week.